Hey everyone. In this video today, I'm going to walk you through how to use ClassPoint to boost student engagement in your classroom without students having to use devices of their own. With ClassPoint's new gamification and presentation tools, students can better interact and engage with your PowerPoint presentations without having to use their own devices. So let's take a look at these features that ClassPoint has to boost up your student engagement without having student devices in your classroom. First, let's gamify your lessons and your students' learning journey by awarding student stars right inside PowerPoint. This will allow them to level up, earn new badges, and you can even show off your student rankings by showing the ClassPoint leaderboard. Integrating this point system right inside PowerPoint makes it quick, easy, and customizable for you to give student stars how you want to. So, for example, if you ask your students a question and somebody raises their hand to answer it, you can go ahead and give that student a star for participating. All of these stars can be tracked over time. That way you can watch students' progress throughout all of your sessions together. For this to happen, you do have to add your class list into PowerPoint. So back here in edit mode, you can click on the class list icon and go ahead and start a new class. So with your class, you can just go ahead, give it a name, give it a class code, and then import your student list. So you can either type out all of your student names or just go ahead and use our template here and import them. Then you can go ahead and continue adding classes for all of the class sessions that you have and that you are teaching. Then when you start your presentation, we can go ahead and select the correct class for that presentation. So go ahead, click on the class code, and then you can change your class to the right one so that you can begin this gamified learning journey. So this My Class window will become your best friend. This is where you can go ahead and award stars to students for participating in in-class activities or for having good class behavior. And if needed, you can also deduct a star from a student. In addition, with this class list now put into PowerPoint, you can use the name picker. So the name picker is a really fun activity that allows you to randomly select a student's name, and then when it's chosen, you can go ahead and award them a star for their bravery. All of these stars will total up and earn students new level badges. These levels can be customized to suit your needs back in settings of your PowerPoint edit mode. Then throughout your presentation, you can go ahead and check on your student rankings. So you can open up the leaderboard to check on the rankings for that day, or you can go ahead and check out the total stars rank to view the rankings of your students from every class session that you've had together. This gamification learning journey is really going to help your students stay motivated and engaged throughout all of your lessons. In addition to the star reward system, try out the teaching toolkit, all located in one place. Instead of sourcing multiple different applications for a lot of common tools, ClassPoint has integrated 5 different tools right in one centrally located place. That way, you don't have to use lots of different tools. So first, let's go back and talk a little bit more about that name picker. So on the toolbar, you can select the name picker icon and see all of the different options that you have. So with this, you can remove all unwanted silences after asking a question and instead use the name picker to select a student. No favoritism in question. So the name picker that ClassPoint has a wheel view in addition to a card view. And you can even use the auto pick feature to select more than one student at once. Students will definitely stay active and engaged throughout your lessons when you bring up this name picker. Now there's a way for you to search the web right inside PowerPoint without ever having to leave PowerPoint. So to be able to use this, go ahead, click on the embed browser button on your toolbar, and then you can get questions answered, show your students examples, all by searching Google. Pin, bookmark, open multiple tabs, use this browser as if you were exploring the web outside of PowerPoint. Only difference is now you can go ahead and insert a screenshot of that web page right into your PowerPoint presentation. That way you can go ahead and annotate right on it. Another part of this teaching toolkit is a timer. During presentations, timers are often used for breaks, activities, or time management purposes, and now you can access one right from the ClassPoint toolbar. So go ahead, click on that timer icon, and you can go ahead, set your timer, and even use a stopwatch for any of your activities as needed. Another presentation tool that you can try is Draggable Objects. Draggable Objects are parts of your slide that are movable during your PowerPoint presentations. With just the click of a button, I can go ahead and move around my content on my slides. This provides me with way more freedom than what PowerPoint animations have to offer. And all I have to do is just enable any non-animating text, images, or shapes to be draggable during my presentation. Then, during my presentation, I can click on the Draggable Objects icon on the toolbar and begin moving around my content as needed. The last piece of this teaching toolkit is the best annotation tools that PowerPoint has to offer. ClassPoint recently updated their annotation tools. That way it's a little bit more accessible for all users wanting to annotate on their slides, especially those without a touchscreen device. So on the toolbar, you'll see that there's pen tools and highlighter tools. Then color and the thickness can be changed right on the toolbar. Plus, you might notice that there's now the ability to add different shapes and text right onto your slides. This way you can show your information and emphasize any points exactly how you would like. If you do run out of room, you can go ahead and insert a whiteboard slide into your presentation. So you can insert one of these blank ones or a template that you have and created that you'll use for a lot of your different classes. Once that slide is inserted, you can go ahead and continue to annotate and share that information. And lastly, let's not forget our laser pointer. So if you want to highlight or call out any other information, you can use the laser pen or go ahead and click on that middle button of your mouse to bring up a spotlight. That way you can reveal information as you would like. With these ClassPoint features, your presentations will never look the same. You can engage and interact with your students using new technology every day, not just on days where students have their own device. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions, let us know. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, leave us a comment below, give us a thumbs up. You know the drill. I'll see you guys next time.